Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. What person doesn't love a cheeseball? And what kid hasn't taken a cheeseball, thrown it into the air, and tried and catch it in their mouth? Well, today we have a STEM design challenge where we use simple materials like cardboard tubes and rubber bands to make our own cheeseball launcher. Now, this launcher could launch all different kinds of things. We could launch cotton balls, we could launch ping pong balls, we could launch goldfish. We decided to go with cheese balls because we can get a giant vat of cheese balls and have plenty of things to launch. So let's start by pulling this one apart so you can see how simple this is to make. To do that, I'm just going to pull the rubber bands over the pencil and you'll see my launcher slides apart into two pieces. Now, the one thing you need to notice is that one tube, my inner tube, has to be smaller than the other so it can fit inside. But most cardboard tubes are the same size, so what do we do with these? So how do I make one cardboard tube smaller than the other? I need a pair of scissors. I'm just going to cut right down the center of one of the tubes. What that allows me to do is to shrink the diameter of that cardboard tube so it fits inside. Now all I need to do is tape this up and I have my inner tube ready to go. So now we have our cardboard tube taped up, but we want to be careful. When I slide this in, if I make that inner cardboard tube too small, it'll actually allow the cheese ball to get wedged in right between the two tubes and then my launcher won't work. Now keep in mind that these are paper towel tubes, but toilet paper tubes also would work. You would just have a shorter launcher. And you can see with this version, I just use smaller toilet paper tubes. Now the next step is to cover this end with tape so the cheese ball doesn't fall through like this. That's not good. Now, the one thing we figured out when we made our first version of this is that if you pull the tape too tight, the cheese ball kind of wants to roll off. So you'll notice I put a little bit of a dip in the tape. So now it cradles the cheese ball perfectly. Now, the next thing we need to do is put in our pencil stop. And we have some choices to figure out where we put that pencil stop. You'll notice on this design, I put the pencil stop right at the end of the inner chamber, but we have an interesting problem happen when we do this. It's hard to grab, there's no handle. So how do we get around that? Well, here I just simply bent a paper clip that wrapped around, which allows me to pull back. I could also use a pipe cleaner. Now I have my pipe cleaner wrapped around and that gives me a handle. But what we decided to do with this version is leave our tube a little bit long and it's the perfect handle grip that really allows me to pull back on our cheese ball launcher. So what I'm going to do is slide this in, figure out how much of the tube I need to really get a firm grip, and then figure my pencil stop has to go somewhere around there. Now we have another problem. If I'm going to use a hole punch to put a hole in my cardboard tube, my hole punch is only going to be able to go up so far. And that's really what limits me. That's why we've put it close to the end here, because I can use my hole punch to punch the hole. If I'm going to use something else to punch the hole, I could use something like a sharpened pencil or a screwdriver, but I want to be careful that I'm not stabbing through into my hand. So you always want to do this on a table. Make it safe. So we have our pieces assembled. You can see they slide together. Now, there's one other thing I have to think about before I attach the energy source, and that's over time, as this pencil slams into that cardboard tube, going to start to really bend it down. So I need to reinforce that with something like tape, just so it makes this more sturdy. So you might want to ring some tape around that, even put some tape down inside, but just make sure it's nice and smooth so that my inner cardboard tube slides right through. Now it's time to give our energy source, something that's going to power our cheese ball through the air. For that, we're going to use rubber bands, and it's really up to you how many rubber bands you use. We suggest you start with two rubber bands running down each side and get some measurements to see how far that cheese ball goes. And then you can start adding some rubber bands to see if you can redesign your cheese ball launcher to make the cheese ball go even further. So how do we attach the rubber bands? Well, I need to put two slits on the top of my tube, and we're going to zoom in so you can take a closer look at how that's done. So we're zoomed in so you can see I really don't need to make slits that go all that far down. In fact, it's hard to see. So I'll pull this back and you can see how the rubber band fits right in that slit. Now, it's safe to say that if I tug on that rubber band, the slit's gonna open up. So I definitely need to go back over this with some tape to make sure that does not rip out. Now, do the same thing to the other side. two quick slits to make a little cardboard tab. Open that up. And now all I have to do is tape this closed, and I'm almost ready to use my launcher. So now we have our energy source attached and ready to go. Now keep in mind, the further back we stretch this rubber band, the more energy we're putting into our launcher. So if I'm using a shorter launcher and my rubber band doesn't get stretched as far, it's not gonna have as much energy. It kind of makes me think, I wonder what would happen if we tried to make a really long launcher. We put a whole lot of energy into that rubber band. I think that's our next build design. So let's see how this works. I'm gonna slide my inner tube in. I'm gonna stretch one rubber band down, hold it. I'm gonna stretch the other rubber band, and now I have a launcher that slides back and forth. I think we're ready to give it a shot. So now we're ready to test fire. Load your cheese ball. Now I'm gonna launch it this way just so we can see what kind of launch happens here. So we'll hold it sideways, pull it back. 3, 2, 1. That cheese ball flew across the room. Let's try another launch. Load up the cheese ball, lower angle, 3, 2, 1, fire. What's so cool about this is we could use our cheese ball launcher to do all kinds of things and collect all kinds of measurements. Maybe we put a target, and our goal is to try and see if we can get it into that target, a waste basket, a trash can, a laundry basket. And if we're not shooting it far enough, we're gonna have to figure out, how do we increase our energy source? Maybe our target's up high like a basketball net, and we're trying to make a basket. And if we're not launching high enough, we have to figure out our launch angle. Maybe we could actually track the launch angle of our cheese ball launcher and see if we're launching it at a 90 degrees, how high it can go. We can take a trip outside and measure how high our cheese ball launches into the air. There's so many things we can do. The other thing I want to point out is you can see we have a design flaw. My launcher's already starting to break down, and that's normal and it's going to happen. And what we need to do as scientists is figure out how do we go back and redesign this to reinforce this and make this stronger. If this is the weakest part of my launcher, I have to fix that and make it better. At Fun Science Demos, we're always trying to redesign our ideas to figure out how to make them better. In fact, if you can come up with a better way to reinforce this end, put it in the comments section. There are so many things we can do with our cheese ball launcher. In this case, you can see I have two rubber bands attached. Well, I added two extra rubber bands for more energy. We can talk about designing a new handle for our cheese ball launcher and see if we can design something that's easier to use. Best of all, we can also talk about shooting more than one cheese ball at a time. And I think it's fitting that we try and load up our cheese ball launcher with as many cheese balls and see what happens when we try to launch them. If you want to learn some more STEM design challenge ideas, or if you want to learn more about forces in motion, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when you get to launch something. 3, 2, 1.